This feeling that you can put your work out into the world, be it on the pitch or on a record, and for that to reverberate through people and through communities, I think is such a special thing that unites football and music.
You actually have twangled my brain. I'm from West London. I grew up in a place called Mozart. Growing up in the ends made me the person I am. It gave me the thick skin that I have. And it also gave me that base of multiculturalism that's influenced me for everything I do.
I think I was very blessed to be raised around West London. I draw like everyday inspiration from it, just from the way I dress and the music I make, not even like consciously, but subconsciously, because it's just what I'm around really.
The surroundings of London just gets me excited. Just being around it, all the atmosphere is a nice feeling to be around.
Where I grew up, you come from your house to this high street that's just like buzzing, full of energy, like different dialects. It's people from all over the country. Liverpool's kind of known for this like artistic kind of background and the Portobello and Carnival, that soundboy clash culture, and you always felt that love for music in the end.
If you're a youth from ends, the two things you know you can do regardless of your background is sports and music.
I started writing bars because man was bored in the ends. We went from freestyling, talking rubbish to actually going to the studio and writing music, because just a couple of my friends used to be like, hey yo, when you freestyle it's hard.
Kids are just making things at home in their bedroom. They're putting it out on like SoundCloud or Spotify or whatever DSPs and going viral overnight. Football players are referenced. And then those football players will be like, before match, like listening to those songs, like hearing their own names being rocked.
Money on the left, Salah on the right. Some of the greatest I've ever seen in my life. Sadio came from the pain and strife to be one of the best in the world. That's life.
The grind man them, yeah, want to play football. We want to be ballers. And I know a couple of ballers wish they can spit some bars. You see it all the time. Like, it's lovely when you see the footballers in the changing room getting gas to a song, or when they're celebrating a win. Music is always in the background. You always say, my brother, how you doing, man?
I'm blessed, bro. How are you, man? You good? I'm in the change room. I'm focused. I'm listening to my music. I'm getting ready.
That is part of the build-up. You'd say 100%.
100%. Like, you want to get ready and feel pumped for the game.
For an artist that's featured on the FIFA soundtrack, it's a bit of a badge of honour. Like, I feel like to know that your sound is playing to so many millions of people around the world who all think and believe and are into the same sort of stuff that you are, that's like a massive moment.
Loaded Up Volta, the first song, I swear on my mother's life, the first song to play on Volta was my song.
FIFA,
the
I see it.
I could have cried, bruv. I've been playing FIFA since I was a little youth.
You work hard to be in the game. You want to be in FIFA. You want to be a player where you can say, oh, I'm playing with myself in the game. Like, this is crazy. Without teammates and team, you can't get anywhere in life. You know what I mean? I feel like to myself, sport is not an individual thing. No matter if you score 40 goals a year, you're not going to get them by yourself. You're going to have to get them with the team.
In football, you have like a striker, like they're the main person. Like maybe you could compare that to an artist and they're the sort of star of the show. But you can't just have a team full of strikers, do you know what I mean? You need a goalie, you need someone at the back holding it down.
I wouldn't have been able to get anywhere in music, TV, whatever it was, without my friends.
I can always trust them for like an honest opinion, a brutally honest opinion, and not from a place of, you know, bitterness, but actually like genuine love.
That's one of the most important things to have around you. The criticism you can get from someone that's real with you is always going to be better than someone that's just trying to be in the good books. Real friends, they can offend you about your art because their intention is for you to be better. It's sick that we're talking about things like this.
プレイステーション